Hey guys, salut mes amis, och hallo gubbar, Maxim here. If you go on Steam, click on games, click on personal game data, you will now get tons of personal information. This is in compliance for the EU's GDPR.
But Maximo, what is GDPR?
GDPR allows us to see our personal information that Valve has stored from us. Now, what's really interesting about this page is how much Valve knows about you and how much data they have. Damn, it's a lot. I mean, look, literally your entire life is here. Or at least for people that are like me, addicted to CSGO. There's so much stuff here that you probably want to check out yourself if you haven't already, but I'm just going to go through the most interesting bits. Under matchmaking, you have some basic stats about wins, ties, losses, etc. But what I really like about this page is the last match info. Now this tells me how long ago I played matchmaking, so I know roughly when to go back before I lose my rank again. After I've played a match and I win, I stop playing matchmaking. Then I go back a month later and I repeat the process. I'm such an inspiring person. I like the fact that I haven't touched Demolition for over 2 years, but it's still 2016, so it's not like it's really that long ago. Under competitive matches, you get every single match you've played on matchmaking. And I mean every single match. Since the beginning of time, oh, I mean CSGO. If you download Ban Checker for Steam, which is for Chrome, you can find these new buttons here. Clicking on Load Whole Match History will, like it says, load your entire match history. Now this will take a while, depending on how many matches you have. For me, it took around 5 minutes. Now, after loading every single match that I've played, I noticed that my first competitive game for CSGO was back in 2012. And apparently, I was carrying my team, so it's nice to see that nothing's changed. But the fact that I started playing in 2012 comes as a big surprise to me, since I've always believed that I started playing much later. This just proves that if you really believe something, it starts to become your reality. And it also just proves that my memory is horrible. With the ban checker, you can also check loaded matches for bans. This will show you everyone that got banned from each match that you've played. I highly recommend that you try this out. There's also a section for Wingman matches, which is the same, and also Operation Hydra matches and casual matches. Operation Mission Partners shows the people that have done the co-op missions together with you, when there's actually an operation available in the game, which by the way, we're still waiting for. I've played them all together with Svedjehead, a friend who's currently playing in FPL, and one of my best friends, Edhead. Nice. Under commendations, you have people that have commended you while in game. But even more interestingly, you can find your reports. Now this is people you've reported for different reasons. Just the fact that Valve stores this information is very interesting. I wonder if they take it into consideration when improving their anti-cheat, or more specifically VACnets, but I doubt it. It's still good to know that each time we've reported someone, it doesn't just go out in the air. It is saved somewhere. You can also check if these people got busted in the end. I'm actually very proud of my results. Most people that I've reported have gotten banned. So it's not like I'm just some raging watermelon or whatever. You also have your major pick-ems, leaderboards, and you have your loadouts. In short, all this information is truly awesome to see, but still a bit scary to know that it exists. The most surprising thing for me was to learn that I've been playing since 2012. What about you? Do you have any fun things to share regarding your matches or anything like that? Let me know down below. Make sure you follow me on Twitter if you want to see what everyone is talking about. No one is talking about any... I mean, people are talking, but I... never mind. And I'm also using Instagram. We could also use some more people on Discord. I'll see you guys in the next one, and go banana.